Good morning and welcome back to Outlook Portland. I'm David Bragdon, your host. I'm talking about getting to and from work or to the store with Oliver Jones from the United Kingdom and Gail Ackerman, chair of the Oregon Transportation Commission. We were talking about what you've been advocating is rather than necessarily building a lot of big new things, that the public needs to see benefit from a lot of little things that keep traffic moving.
Yeah, that's quite right. We had a phrase in the report called small is beautiful, and we looked at lots and lots of projects.
Now, small is beautiful, it got talked about a lot in the 1970s.
Yeah.
But
and what was interesting is we took the evidence, so we looked at the kind of the returns on investment and actually put it on a big graph, and it was really noticeable that some of the smaller schemes, you know, looking at junctions or perhaps adding an extra carriage to a railway system, little things like that were extremely good in terms of returns compared to the very big projects.
Well, Gail, if you agree with that philosophy, what are some of the sort of little things where the public in Oregon can start to see some benefit more quickly?
Take one really simple example that people see. Remember when you get stopped because a train goes by and so traffic backs up for blocks and blocks and blocks because of the train? Well, if you grade separate the railroad from the road, that grade separation investment is really not nearly as expensive generally as an interchange on a freeway. And yet that can significantly reduce congestion in certain downtown areas. And so that's one example. But another example is to look at a freeway like 217 and maybe instead of adding lanes, which is going to be astronomically expensive on 217 because it's developed on either side, that you could close certain access points so there aren't as many access points and reconfigure the ramps on many of those access points so that you don't have weaves as you do the merges.
So then the through traffic moves a little bit better.
Flow is much better and the whole system operates more efficiently.
People start to see that benefit a little faster as well as it being more cost
effective. That's right. I think people know those kind of things can take 6 months, 12 months rather than the 5 years that a big project might take, and without any of the disruption as well in terms of public works and blocking the road or the rail system. So I think people see that they're getting an instant benefit from funding these small
schemes. The bottom line, it seems to me that a series of smaller projects may be more cost effective. People start to see the benefit and then...
They may be. Yeah. Now, one of the big differences between the United Kingdom and Oregon that I'm very interested in is that the economic benefit analysis that was done in the United Kingdom contrasted England with France and Spain, where
you basically say you have an existing network that you need to optimize as opposed to building a new network.
And they have a real density of development, where in Spain in particular they're wide open spaces.
Where would you say Oregon is on that continuum?
Well, the problem I struggle with is we have some areas in Oregon that are growing very, very, very rapidly, like Central Oregon, the Rogue Valley, where we're seeing 50 to 100% population increases over a 10-year period. Well, you've got to build new facilities in a situation like that.
Yeah, at the same time, Oregon's a very rural state with these huge rural areas.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think we say small is beautiful, but it's not always going to be enough. And let's be clear, particularly with a new population growth, you need new infrastructure on occasions. Of course you do. But given that often money is tight, if you do want to get the maximum return, sometimes small is beautiful, particularly I think in existing areas where it's easier to do these small schemes than it is to do big disruptive projects.
Well, I want to shift gears here a little bit, so to speak, and talk a little bit about the environmental impacts of transportation. We're realizing that with global warming, emissions from automobiles is a huge, huge part of the global warming picture and how we build and operate a transportation system, not just for cars, but some of the alternatives to cars, is a very important thing that we can do locally and statewide with regard to the environment and global warming. Mm-hmm. So when we come back from this break, I want to talk a little bit about sort of what some of the thinking is in England about that and then certainly what that means to us here at home in Oregon and some of the choices that we make in how we invest money and how we live our lives relative to transportation and global warming. When we come back on Outlook Portland.
Outlook Portland will continue in a moment.